remember Job? Job was a paradigm of virtue. Everywhere I read, the word was that his name was Job, that he was perfect, he was upright, one that feared God and eschewed evil. In the book of Ezekiel, about 14:14, when the Lord is speaking through the prophet, he speaks about Job, and he points out that these three men, Noah, Daniel, and Job, if they were in Israel, the Lord said, I wouldn't deliver everybody because of them. I would only deliver them because of their righteousness, saith the Lord. Their righteousness will not be good enough for everybody. They could only get out themselves. Then in James 5:11, he talks about Job. He says, behold, we count them happy which endure. Ye have heard of the patience of Job. By any stretch of the imagination, the outside declarations about Job are all wonderful and beautiful. But then I read Job speaking about himself. And he says, wherefore I abhor my faith and repent in dust and ashes. And then one begins to wonder, how can Job have so many accolades by scripture? And when he deals with himself, sees himself as so little or nothing. And it seems to me that that is the power of Job. When he realizes, if I'm to be anything, God's got to do it. Because no matter how folk pat me on the back, I know myself. I know the thoughts I had to fight in order to do the will of God. I know the things I wouldn't want anybody to know about me. I know the struggle I have in the night and the things that go through my mind. And I have to admit to God, Lord, when folk pat me on the back, I'm still not worthy. And if you don't help me, I'll never make it. Oh, glory to God. I wish I were in a church today where I could just look at somebody and say, help me. Because when I look at myself, it's not like how you see me. But I see myself empty. I see myself ragged. And if I don't lean on God, I never have a single victory in my life. And when God gets you to that place, he'll bring you up and give you power to overcome.